A function is a reusable code block that will execute only when it's called. To create one, we'll start by typing void, followed by the function's name, an optional parameter list, and a code block. The void keyword simply says that this method will not return a value. The naming convention for functions is the same as for variables, a descriptive name with each word initially capitalized except for the first one. This method here will simply print out a text message. To invoke it from the main method, we type the method's name followed by a set of parentheses. The parentheses are used to pass arguments to the function. To pass arguments, we must first add them to the function declaration in the form of a comma-separated list. A function can take any number of arguments, and they can have any data types. We just need to make sure to call the function with the same type and number of arguments. We can specify a default value for an argument by assigning it a value inside of the parameter list. Now, if we don't specify that argument when calling the method, the default value will be used instead. For this to work, it's important that the arguments with default values are to the right of the arguments with no default values. A function in C++ can be defined multiple times with different arguments. This is a powerful feature called method overloading, which allows a method to handle a variety of parameters transparently to the programmer using the method. A function can also be used to return a value. We then replace the void keyword with the data type we want the function to return, and add the return keyword to the function's body, followed by an argument of the specified return type. Return is a jump statement that causes the current function to exit and return the specified value to the place where the method was called. We can here, for example, pass the return value as an argument to the output stream, since the function now evaluates to an integer. If we want to, we can also use the return keyword in a void function to exit before the end block is reached. Note that although the main method is set to return an integer type, we do not have to explicitly return any value. This is because the compiler will automatically add a return zero statement to the end of the main method. An important thing to keep in mind in C++ is that functions must be declared before they can be called. This does not mean that we have to implement the function before it is called. It only means that we need to specify the function's header in the beginning of the source file so that the compiler knows that the function exists. This kind of forward declaration is known as a prototype. The argument names in the prototype does not need to be included, only the data types must be specified.